Hello, my name is Kim, professor of Kalasangam University, India. Today's topic is second lecture for the AD convert, for the AD convert and the DA convert. This time, let me explain about the quantization. Last my lecture number the 12, I explained the sampling, what is sampling, and this time let me explain the quantization. Okay, first let me review the last lecture. Now I introduced continuous time signal x over t. This means this vertical, horizontal axis. Time is continuous also. Vertical axis amplitude, this is continuous. We call this continuous time signal. Otherwise, we can say analog signal. We call this analog signal. Okay. And first, if we convert continuous time to discrete time by sampling, we call this discrete time signal x over n, like this. Time is a discrete, not continuous. In this case, the interval of time, we call this a sampling period. Now this 0.25 seconds. Next, what do we have to do is convert continuous amplitude to discrete amplitude. We call this, as I said here, quantization. Quantization. And this signal, we call this signal digital signal. Means this time also discrete. Amplitude also discrete. We call it digital signal. Also, this digital signal can be used in computer. Okay, then how to quantize? Quantize means we need to convert the continuous amplitude to discrete amplitude. For this, let me assume one signal whose maximum amplitude equal 3 and the minimum amplitude equal 0. And for quantization, we need 2 bits. From this, we can calculate the number of steps is 2 to the power 2 equal 4 steps we have. And also, from this, we can decide the step size. Step size equal maximum amplitude minus minimum amplitude by number of steps by 1. By 1 because of 0 is there. Therefore, in this case, the step size equal 1. Then, let's see this table. This, okay. Now, input x of n varies 0 to 3.1. And also, for quantization, there are two kinds. One is truncation, one is rounding. Okay, one more time. Two kinds of quantization. One is by truncation and rounding. Okay, then here, this is real amplitude. This is quantized amplitude. This is a quantized error. Error means difference between real amplitude and the quantized. Okay, for example, real amplitude equal 0.0001, then the quantized, the amplitude equal 0 by truncation. Then error is error equal 0.0001 minus 0 equal 0.0001. Okay. And real amplitude equal 1.001. By truncation, quantized amplitude equal 1. Okay, 1. Then the error is 1.0001 minus 1 equal also error equal 0001. And real amplitude equal 0.5, the by truncation you can get this is also 1. Then the error is 1.5 minus 1 equal 0.5. Okay. Also, real amplitude 1.999. By truncation, quantized amplitude goes to 1. Therefore, error equal 1.9999 minus 1 equal 0.09999. Okay, 2 goes to 2, error equal 0. 3 goes to 3, error equal 0. From this, maximum error is, you can see here, maximum error is this one, 0.9999 means 1, because the value is 9999, also error equal to there. Okay? This means, you can see here, this is a step size. Okay, now, in case of a truncation, maximum error is the step size. Okay, let's see the rounding quantization. Rounding quantization here. Okay, rounding. Now, real value is 0.0001 goes to 0. Therefore, quantized error equal 0.0001 minus 0 equal 0.0001. And this amplitude 1.001 quantized by rounding means 1. Therefore, error equal 0.0001. And amplitude equal 1.5. Rounding means go to 2. Therefore, error equal 0.5 minus 2 equal 0.5. Okay. And this one, rounding is 2. Therefore, error equal 0.0001. And the rounding 2, error equal 0. Rounding 3, equal 0. From this, what we can know is the maximum error equal this one. This unit ball. This means step size by 2. Okay. Now from this, what we can know is anyway, the maximum error, the less the better. Therefore, in this case, truncation error, maximum error equal delta. In case of rounding, maximum error delta by 2. Therefore, this is better than truncation. Also, this error depends on this delta. Delta is step size. Okay. Then how to reduce the quantized error? This depends on delta. We need to reduce the delta. Then how to reduce this one? Then we need this one step size. Okay. We increase the step size. For this, we need number. We increase the number of bit. From this, we can reduce the quantization error. Okay. One more time, let me summarize. For reducing the quantization error, we need to use the rounding one and also reduce the step size. For this, we need to increase number of bits. For example, here we 2, 3, 4, 5, or 16, 32 like that. We need to increase the number of bits, then we can reduce the quantization error. Okay, thank you so much for your watching. Today I explained how to quantize in magnitude, in amplitude. Also, how to reduce the quantization error. That means increasing the number of bits of quantization. Okay, next topic is recovery. Means discrete time signal to converting here to here. What is? Let me explain. Please look forward to next lecture. Thank you very much.